Good morning, everybody. Hope you're having a good morning so far. Really excited about Crowns Camp going on. I've already gotten some emails here and there from you guys, some Twitters. And man, I'd really love to hear your story just as we go of what God's been showing you. You could email us at Casting Crowns, Mark@castingcrowns.com, and just put in the subject line Crowns Camp Day 1 or Crowns Camp Day 2, and just let me know what's going on and what you're getting out of what we've been talking about. Last night we talked about looking at Psalm 63, and I'm just going to tell you some things that God's been showing me, but I'd love to hear what God's showing you guys as well. So get on there and email me. Also, Twitter.com, if you're familiar with that, is Mark Hall CC. No spaces, just Mark Hall CC on Twitter, and we can keep up with each other that way too. But Psalm 63, let's dive in. Verse 1, O God, you are my God, and earnestly I seek you. My soul thirsts for you, my body longs for you, in a dry and weary land where there is no water. I've seen you in the sanctuary, and I've beheld your power and your glory. Because your love is better than life, my lips will glorify you. I will praise you as long as I live, and in your name I will lift up my hands. The thing that stuck out to me is the last part of that. In a dry and weary land where there is no water. Last night we talked about the Spider-Man ride. I got Spidey back here behind me. We talked about the fact that, riding a 3D ride without the 3D glasses is not a very smart move. And also going into my day and walking into work, walking into school, walking into homeschool, being a mother, a dad, all these things. If we go into these tasks and these journeys without the eyes of Jesus on, we are not going to see things as they are. We're not going to see the unseen things that we talked about in 2 Corinthians 4:18, right? We're not going to see those things. We're going to operate on our gut, on what seems right at the time, on what the pros and cons list say, and that's the way we're going to run our life, and we're going to regret it, right? Some of us, we're already regretting it. We're trying to get over the past goof-ups that we've done from seeing with our eyes, right? Psalm 63 says something pretty cool in the very first verse. It says, my soul yearns for you, my body thirsts for you in this dry and weary land where there is no water. You know the only reason this psalmist, David here, the only reason this psalmist thirsts for God, the only reason his soul longs for God and he thirsts for him, you know why that is? Because he understands that he lives in a land that is dry and there is no water. He understands he's living in a wasteland. And until you and I wrap our minds around the fact that this world has nothing to offer us, we'll never thirst for God. It'll always be, God will be nothing more than a 911. He'll be our contingency plan. He's our plan B. If everything else, he is the safety chute. He is what we're going to go to at the last minute when it doesn't seem like we're going to get out of trouble. It doesn't seem like it's going to get any better. Then we're going to turn for God. That's not thirst. That's just desperation. That's just, oh no, I better do this other thing. I better try this other thing. God's a plan B, not a person, right? Well, When I've started praying and I've gotten there in some areas and I haven't in others, is that the things that the world says are going to complete me are not going to complete me. Success is not going to complete me. People are not going to complete me. Popularity is not going to complete me. It's a cup with a hole in it. It's always going to leave me thirsty. And one of the things God has to open my eyes to first is that I live in a dry and weary land where there is no water. And I can't make my own way. Okay, so here's where I think we're going with this. We got to answer some hard questions about ourselves. We got to ask God to open our eyes to some truth. It's always easy to see truth about other people's lives. Here's what I believe you should do, brother. But man, when it gets up in our business, it's kind of harder to see it because we're really not sure if we want to, right? When we look into the mirror of God's word in this, the big question is this. Why am I not closer to Jesus than I am? Could it be because Jesus is still sort of my plan B in a lot of areas? Am I surrendered to him in some areas, but in others, I'm still holding out. Like I think I might have a better idea for this thing. I want to challenge you guys to look at something. John chapter 4. That's where I want you guys to go. this morning. I want you to read through this morning and dig into the story of Jesus and the woman at the well. Because what happens in this story is the very same thing we've been talking about. There's this lady who thinks she knows what she's looking for, and she meets the answer, and she meets truth. And Jesus is talking to her about living water, and she's still dragging it back to earthly water. What I want you to do is just dig into this story. You can start at verse 1, and let's see here. We can go on all the way through verse 26, 1 through 26 of chapter 4. As you dig into John chapter 4 and dig into the story of this woman at the well and who she was and where she'd been, and man, see the similarities between her and us in a lot of ways. Man, ask God to show you stuff. God's not hiding from you. Life's not some crazy riddle that you've got to find the next clue so he'll lead you to the next thing. Man, if your heart is set on honoring God, if your heart is set on pleasing him and knowing him, man, he's not going to steer you off a cliff. James chapter 1 says this: if we desire wisdom, ask God for wisdom. Man, he gives it to us freely without finding fault, as long as we ask believing. So when we go into God's word, go into it saying, God, I need wisdom, and I'm believing you for it. Show me truth about myself. Show me truth about my family. Show me truth about the things that I'm still holding on to and not wanting to trust you with. Because in a lot of ways, we got a lot of atheism still creeping around in our lives. You know, we say, man, I believe in you for this, but I don't believe in you for that. It's not something we'd ever say out loud, but it's in us, man. We've got faith in some areas, and we're not believing God at all in some other areas. And man, some of those times, the little pieces of us, they don't ever meet. We don't have to face up to truth. You get in the Word, it's not like some guy singing a song, can't change the station. You know what I'm saying? You got to listen to what he's saying. Dig into this truth and ask God, what do you want me to see about myself? God, I've got to have my eyes on and see myself and the world that I live in before I can be of any use to anybody else around me. So let's dig in. I love you guys. I'm praying for you. And I'm praying God is showing you some amazing things about his love for you, his direction for you, and the plan he has for you guys. And I'll talk to you guys tomorrow morning. God bless.